Thank you, Master Dakota. Here we have the forces of my Lord Somerset finally making their way to the forces here at Temple Gates to do battle, trying to suppress Jack de Molay, put the Knights Templar to the sword, and finally create the end of that order. They're laying out towels. I can't believe they're doing this to me. This is actually a group of Germans who've come to be here at the show. So then they certainly just dropped from the battlefield. Interestingly, these guys have come all the way from Australia in Southwest Germany to be here. They've travelled a very long way. They love this show, they love doing this for you. So just a little interesting piece is we have got some here for war over here. These are a group of Englishmen who are actually portraying a band of Scottish mercenaries. Absolute coincidence. Right, now I'd like to speak to you all about something on a serious note. What we're doing here today is a portrayal of dark and violent times. We do this with the absolute best of intentions. We do it to inform, to entertain, and to support charity. A lot of people are aware of the recent events. I'm not going to dwell on them. Some years we have a minute silence, but I am sick of giving silence for those we've lost. So this year, and I want you all to be ready, and I want you to join in, we are not giving silence to the dead. We are giving noise, we are giving life, and we are giving energy to them. So, on the count of three, all fighters, and I want all of the audience to join me in a huge cheer. One, two, three, and...
Oh!
That doesn't mean we're not going to try and kick in the doors. You get that, right?
That's not very nice!
Let's take it inside! John, don't do it. Please, just, it's already all going wrong. We're not even halfway through the script. Don't do it, this is a family show. Just watch. This is awful. So have you taken command?
Maybe.
Look, somebody's got to take responsibility for all this. Harlem's in there as well. Oh God, I put him in there, didn't I?
Yes.
What?
Yes, he did.
So the guy who's the backup Somerset is in there as well. I know. Right, that's it. You're taking command and you've called for a battle of the champions. How many fighters do you want? Four.
Four champions!
Malay, Somerset! They've called for four champions. Now, a battle of the champions was a way of deciding a fight with as little bloodshed as possible. What they would do is whoever's side's champions won, the losing side would have to leave the field, in this case, cede the fortress, or in so, I can't really play Somerset's forces anymore because he's over there. Would have to leave. Have you found four champions, Malay, of this weird Malay-Somerset alliance? Do we need another champion? Right. You really seriously need to give Somerset a thorough kicking. Because this isn't funny.
The lady in that spot, I know it looks like I turned my coat. But I still want you to cheer for me, okay? Ah, Mr. Traitor!
Oh,
I'll take my finish as well!
Ben! Power!
Power,
smoke.
Right, okay.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, they won't fight until you cheer for them. So on the count of three, if you want them to charge, if you want to give them a really good, hard charge, you need to scream at the top of your lungs. So on the count of three, one, two, three.
Charge!
No, not worth it. Don't do it. Do it properly this time. One, two, three.
Charge!
And in the Battle of the Champions, as far as I could tell, everyone cheated. Honestly, I don't know where to go from there. Have you actually tried? Oh, we've got another marble on the field. Right, you see the red and white shiny one? His name is... Do you see the blue and white shiny one? We call him Wannabe. Right. So have you tried actually knocking on the door? You're going to knock on the door. Excellent. Drive them on, the ladies.
Good, ladies.
We built this battering ram. I say we built it. Honest Jim and a gentleman called Paul Frost spent 3 days building this battering ram specially. And we've actually auctioned off the privilege to christen it. Those two ladies there won, so we've made them commanders of it. Because they are too fine and high to be doing menial work such as this. Go on, really fling it. One of the defenders is dropping grenades on the attackers. Oh, they only go off with a little pop. Did he get fright? Oh! Good shot. The counter fire for the guy over there. See the Vikings there. And if you're wondering why there are Vikings in a medieval battle. Quiet in the cheap seats. They won't even let me get the punchline out. If you're wondering why they're here, so am I. And I'm starting to mean that seriously, guys. Guys. to the polar trade off. As long as we're all happy to play. What is he doing? It's like a dog with a bone. I must confess, years ago when I was allowed to fight on the field here, I discovered that if I did the front side of the sword, wedged in between two boards, you could use it like a crowbar, and just trot along it, pulling all the balls out. It was brilliant. It looks like one of the attackers actually managed to break through the defender's guard. That's pretty dead here. Well, I think he was quickly thrown off the palisade. They never just tried to poke Jack de Belay through a gap in the board. I think the attackers are calling a general withdrawal. Right, ladies and gents, they managed to do some serious damage to the palisade wall. And I do mean serious damage. There were bits that really shouldn't have come off. However, this hasn't been drawn to a conclusion yet. And frankly, I'm at something of a loss. Right, attackers, just so you're aware, the Lord Somerset is there, perched on well as high a spot as he can reach. Be aware, because I want him captured and I want him alive. Right, my lord. What next? So, my lord informs me that there are women and children inside the fortress. And he said he will allow them to surrender them so that they can leave here peacefully and without undue bloodshed. My lord, do you have a trustworthy company of men that can escort them? My lord Malay, the women and children and the infirm and elderly are being offered safe passage off the field away from the carnage. Do you agree? Sorry? I think that's quite possibly the first time you've ever agreed that a real hassle. Make the change. Do you promise? Do you swear? Right, for the audience that missed that, he's just giving it the old, oh yeah, we'll look after them. Well, that first one coming out is definitely infirm, I can confirm that. Okay, children, we'll be be safe for a little while.
Get the ball.
All thanks to the discipline has been learned. I'm putting that as if there were really lots of discipline to begin with.
Yeah,
It's not like anyone there has a reputation for cheating or fighting dirty, is it? Straight in with the knees. You've got a sword in your hand and you've tried that. I've heard someone that. Just a couple of final pieces to finish off with. First of all, we do this because we love it. We train the safety, nobody really gets hurt. So to get them up off the field, we've got a little tradition. You all join in with me on the count of three and say, "May the dead arise." Count of three. 1, 2, 3. May
the dead arise.
On the count of three, we all shout, "The bar is open." 1, 2, 3.
The bar is open.
Right, guys. Come on, get your guys in order. We have one final thing for you before you go. I want one good line on the crowd. On one line, there are so many people to thank for making this possible.
Jack,
the guy who all
goes
on it, the North American make this possible, the catering staff, the volunteers, everyone who has worked so hard to make this show happen for you, and for the charities we support, all deserve a great deal of thanks. Alright, get in one line, start making a bit of noise.